Hi, this is Tanmoy Ray from Suen.com. In this video, I'll talk about how to get into the top 4 universities for masters. There are hundreds of good universities all around the world. In this video, we'll specifically talk about how to get to the top 100 universities in the world. So what does the admission panel look for when it comes to international students? When you're applying to the top universities, it's all about standing out in the crowd. So how to do it? Let's find out quickly. First and foremost, the admission committee will look at your undergraduate GPA percentage. Additionally, they will also look at your college reputation and your rank in the class. If you are aiming at the top universities, you need at least 70-75% in your bachelor's. If you have attended a tier 1 or premium university in your bachelor's, that does help. Similarly, if you have been among the top 10% or top 5% or top 2% in your class, that would increase your admission chances at the top universities. The next critical component that the admission officers will look at are the test scores. So how much do you need to score in order to get admission into these universities? Well, ideally there is no minimum requirement. What you need to do is just look at the average scores for the last 3 years of these universities. But honestly speaking, the higher the better. Now what if you end up with low grades or low test scores? Is that going to be the end of the world? Not really. Of course, excellent test scores and high grades can increase your chances for the admission to top universities, but they alone don't guarantee admission. The top universities do look beyond the test scores and the grades. Let's find out the other ways apart from grades and test scores that can help you to get admission at the top universities abroad. Spend good enough time to research about the programs and the universities, and always try to look beyond the rankings. University rankings are good starting points for your research, but you need to dig much deeper. Once you identify the right programs, now you need to make sure that you stand out in your application. If you love coding and applying for data science or analytics, show off your extra projects that you might have done outside your curriculum. When it comes to extracurriculars, it's better to list out one or two activities rather than listing 10 activities. Maybe you are leading the football team for the last 3 or 4 years in your college. If you have got passion for the NGO and social sector, then demonstrate the involvement for the last 1 or 2 years. 3 months or 6 months, you know, might not help. Once you create a broad list of your targeted universities, get in touch with the current students and alumni of those universities. You can contact those students either on LinkedIn, Facebook, Twitter, or some other social media channels. Alternatively, you can also ask them to meet personally. Contact the faculty members, inquire about their research projects, and discuss your future plans. Keep an eye on the social media and try to figure out the campus culture of your target universities. For the majority of Indian applicants, it's not always easy to visit the campus in person. So always try to engage with universities online, attend the webinars, the info sessions, and any kind of online activities. Show interest, engage with them. Demonstrated interest is a key factor when it comes to admissions to the top universities abroad. It can really help you to stand out in the crowd. These activities can help you to leverage your low grades and average test scores. Additionally, they will also provide you enough information to write your essays, statement of purpose, and scholarship essays. Then comes the SOP, also known as statement of purpose, maybe one of the most important components of your application package. The SOP can make or break your application, and several applicants actually struggle with this part. In the SOP, you need to try to give the readers the feel of who you are. You need to introduce yourself, you need to tell about your interests, motivations, career goals, and importantly, you need to justify why or how this program can actually help you to achieve your career goals. Writing the SOP takes time. It cannot be done overnight. Sometimes it takes weeks, sometimes it takes months. Self-reflection and introspection, they are very important. It's only wise that you start well in advance. I also recommend that you get your draft checked with some of your professors, mentors, friends, or maybe a professional admission consultant. Now we'll move on to the last component of the application kit, the letters of recommendation. So if you're in college, you should take a LoR from a professor or assistant professor lecturer who have taught you at least, you know, 2 or 3 semesters. If you're working in a company, you should take a LoR from an immediate supervisor or reporting manager. If you're taking a letter of recommendation from your vice president or CEO, and if you don't have a close working relationship, those letters might not help. You should give your referees good enough time. Ideally, you should sit with them, you know, and discuss the points that need to be included in the LoRs for your applications. Ideally, you should share your CV and SOP with your referees as well, so that will help them to write the best possible LoR. Your CV, SOP and LoR should complement each other, and that will help you to present a stronger application. If you need more tips and strategies, you know how to get in your top universities, do check our blogs. We have shared, you know, tons of advice and strategies along with tips and examples, like how to write an effective statement of purpose, what to do, what not to do. We have also shared the insights from admission officers and the professors, what they actually look for in SOPs, personal statements and essays. Last but not the least, we have shared multiple strategies and tips on how to get scholarships. So, if you're studying abroad, if you need more tips or if you've got any queries, do let us know in the comments. Feel free to visit our website, www.student.com, and also email us at customer.support@student.com. Thanks. Bye.